All right. Now you have groups, and of course, one of them being the former chair, the chairperson of the National Youth Commission, Ronald Cardema, condemning the COMELEC and Banks decision. First of all, what was the basis for the COMELEC and Bank approving Guanzon's substitution, considering that all the nominees had resigned? It seems for no sudden reason or no, they were not disqualified in any way.
Yes, indeed. All of the nominees resigned, you know, they submitted their notarized affidavits of resignation, stating personal reasons, stating health reasons, stating business, and COMELEC really cannot force them to remain as nominees. So with these resignations, what happened was all the lists of the nominees of P3 PWD were exhausted, and therefore they submitted a new list of nominees, and that was granted in accordance with the rules and, of course, in compliance with sections 8 and 16 of Republic Act 7941 or the Party List Act.
Okay. Now, was it their deceit with the nominees? How can the COMELEC, or was there an abuse of the law? Because Mr. Cardema says he wants to file a case against the nominees who withdrew.
Okay. As always, NYC Chairperson Cardema can always do that. The remedies under the law, the rules are there for him to do that. And we will be facing, if in case COMELEC will be impleaded, we will be facing that in the proper tribunal or forum. But then again, what happened here was that the nominees, as listed, all resigned. Okay? Mm-mm. And in accordance with Section 16 of Republic Act 7941, when all the lists had been exhausted, the party list must submit a new list of nominees. And this is what P3PWD did. They submitted a new list of nominees. Mm-mm.
So technically speaking, under the rules, you can resign for any reason, and you can actually be a nominee without intending to sit.
Okay. Because nobody can force you to remain as a nominee. This is a free country, and we could not really force anyone to remain in position, or even for whatever reason that they have, you must stay there. We cannot do that. COMELEC does not have that power to do that. And because, like again, as I've said, this is a free country. If they really wanted to vacate their post, they vacate their nomination, they can always do that.
Mm-mm. But didn't it already lapse? I mean, one of the issues against former Commissioner Guanzon is she did not actually file during in time for the substitution date.
Yes, indeed. There's Resolution 10717 provides the deadline for the withdrawal and substitution for party list must be filed not later than November 15. However, if you look at the rules really speak of proceedings before the elections. 10717 does not necessarily provide for the rules which happens after the elections. So this indeed happened after the election. All the nominees were exhausted. So ito po yung situation, eh, naubos po yung list nila after the elections, even after having been proclaimed, even after having been issued a certificate of proclamation. So even with that winning seat po, the nominees resigned. So what can COMELEC do? Mm-hmm. Otherwise, there will be a permanent vacancy, and P3PWD itself cured that vacancy by filing a new list of nominees. Ito po yung ginawa nila.
Okay, and it's similar to the Duterte Youth.
It's similar.
But we have to remember, Cardema was disqualified because he was over age. That's
exactly.
One.
That's
and
correct.
Then the other nominees, all four of them, resigned. But were the grounds for the resignation of the nominees of the Duterte Party List Group and the 3PWD similar? Or it doesn't matter, sir?
I don't particularly remember that each and every reason for the resignation of the previous, the Duterte Youth nominees. No? But what's important here is that the reasons cited and the affidavits of resignation were all notarized. They were all under oath. So COMELEC has no other action but to recognize this because they're in compliance. Really, all the filings of P3PWD were in compliance with Resolution 10717 and Republic Act 7941. So it's just a matter of a procedure of accepting this, giving due course, of course, allowing the new list of nominees. Ganun lang
nangyari. So my my last question is, let's move forward. Moving forward, what can be done to prevent, clearly there some kind of abuse in this party list system, especially in the nominees? For example, if you run for Congress, right, congressman in a certain district, there are specific rules before you can actually be substituted, even if you run for national office. But it seems here that all these rules are excused at some point and anyone can substitute, which can be quite dangerous in the future, because you can have a nominee campaigning during the campaign period and another person sitting when the party list group has won. And that makes all the difference for the voter. So what can be done so this won't be abused?
Okay. So we really have to put everything into proper perspective. In the legislative districts, the candidate really is the person himself. So
exactly.
the voters will vote for whoever they like. It's really a person-to-person interest. Now, in the case of party lists, the candidate really is the party list representative and their advocacy and their organization. So the nominees are mere representatives of that party list organization, which in itself is a candidate. So
parang pwede ka gumamit ng artista, 'di ba? Ang mangyayari with your definition, pwede ka gumamit ng artista as a nominee, bayaran mo yung artista, and when the party list wins, yung artista will resign and then the real nominee sits in, substitute.
Yes. Two points po. First, there's a publication requirement for that. So, pinapublish po yung nominees ng party list so that the people will know, even if the party list group is really the candidate, these are the nominees.
Was Rowena Guanzon ever published?
Okay. And under the rules, they have until June 19 because they filed their documents on June 14. They have until June 19 to file to cause the publication of the list of nominees. So yung po, no, ipapublish naman yung list of nominees nila.
Oh.
And public at large can still file any case they want. If they want to file a petition for disqualification or to disqualify the nominees, they could still do that. So yung publication requirement is there. Really, there is a need perhaps to amend the law, but until such law is amended, COMELEC is tied with under Section 8 and Section 16. Siguro perhaps in the future po, Congress will be amending this, perhaps providing rules or provision which gives the specific rules after the elections. But until such time po, COMELEC is tied under, again, Section 8 and Section 16.
Okay. Now, when will Ms. Guanzon receive her official certificate?
Okay. They must still, in accordance with the decision yesterday, The grant is it must be subjected to the publication requirement. So they have until June 19, they must comply with that. Mm. The rule says that upon filing, they have 5 days to comply with the publication requirements. And within 3 days of that publication, they must submit the proof of publication to the law department. So they must comply with that. After that, and then it will be submitted to the NBAC, and then then NBAC will be issuing, of course, if all these requirements are completed, we'll be issuing the necessary certificates of proclamation.
All right. Thank you very much, Rex, for joining me today. Thank you.
Thank you very much and good morning.
All right. I'll see you again soon.